Hi everybody, this is Crystal. I'm coming at you again with another video. Today's subject is pet care. And on the screen, you're gonna see a bunch of pictures of a cute little gray cat. And that's my cat, his name is Chirpy. And he was born in my backyard, so I took him in when he was a kitten. And he's my little baby, so I'm gonna basically be talking about dogs and cats in this video. So without further ado, here are my tips. First, consider nonprofit organizations' mobile clinics when it comes to getting your pet spayed or neutered. Chirpy was neutered for free via PETA. People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals. He was ear-tipped when he was fixed. I don't particularly like the fact that he was ear-tipped, but at the time, I didn't know that I was going to keep him as my own personal pet. He was supposed to be a member of a colony, and they ear-tip them so they can tell when they release them back into the wild so that they can tell whether they've been fixed or not. They don't have to go and trap the cats a second time and open them up for another surgery and all of that kind of stuff. So it's basically for researchers and other pet care people can see at a glance who has been fixed and who has not. And you can tell by the ear being notched on the left side. So I can understand why they do it. I don't particularly care for it, but Chirpy is still a gorgeous cat, and if I was going to keep him privately, I would have never, agreed for the ear to be tipped. But what's done is done, and he's still gorgeous. So there's that. As far as this free or cheap spaying or neutering, Spay HR is another one in my area. So you could just do a little bit of internet search for ones in your area. Be warned that they have income requirements or limited time offers or things like that. So read the brochure or the webpage carefully and ask a lot of questions so that you will know whether you qualify or not and what you're getting into. So that's how you can save money when it comes to getting your pet fixed, when it comes to being spayed or neutered. Also, if you adopt from a shelter, which is, the ideal way to go, the pet is spayed or neutered before he or she even leaves the shelter, and is all done at a low cost. So that's another thing to consider if you're looking into getting a pet. My second tip is when it is for routine veterinary care. For routine veterinary care, consider a clinic located inside of a pet store. They tend to be a lot cheaper than regular vets, and they have upfront pricing. They tend to offer preventative care like shots, deworming, just minor things like that. If your pet is already very old or already has a chronic condition like diabetes, or he or she has already been injured, this isn't the place for you. But for regular preventative care on a relatively young and healthy pet, I would definitely recommend going to one of those pet store clinics. I know Carelot has a clinic that's located in their pet store, and so does Pet Supplies Plus. The clinic in Pet Supplies Plus is called the PAWS, P-A-W-S clinic. I also know that the chain Petco has a monthly clinic that is usually held on Saturdays where your pet can get his or her preventative care done. So these clinics tend to operate on a reduced schedule. Like most vets or regular vets are open Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. These clinics are open weird hours like maybe Tuesday, Saturday, and Wednesday from 11 to 4 or something like that. So my advice is to do your homework, call before you go, and definitely read the website. Okay, and my last tip today is to practice excellent home care to reduce vet bills in the future. For example, I brush Chirpy's teeth every day. I use a special pet toothpaste, and I also use a toddler toothbrush, and I brush his choppers every day to reduce the need for expensive dental cleanings later down the line, because they'll have to put the pet under anesthesia and it costs several hundred dollars. So just brush the teeth every day, or at least as often as you can. I also feed him a very good diet. In my opinion, wet food is the best food for cats, because dry food causes kidney and urinary stones and problems, especially in male cats. Male cats are especially prone to this. The problem is that cats are desert creatures and they don't drink enough water. So therefore, this causes all these bladder problems, and dry food just exacerbates that. So my advice is to feed them a wet food diet so that you'll know that they're getting the proper water content. A lot of people say that dry food cleans the teeth, but cats really don't chew their food long enough for their teeth, for this to have any effect on their teeth. They don't chew long enough. They kind of gulp their food down if you ever watch them eat. So I prefer a wet food diet for Chirpy and all cats really. And I wouldn't tell you anything that I wouldn't do for my own pet. I'm an animal lover, and you don't have to take my word for any of this. You can look it up on your own. And I also include a few links in the description bar below. So those are my tips for today for pet care. I love you all. Check out my music when you get a chance. There's something for everyone on my new album entitled Stripped. And please subscribe. Have a great day, and I will talk to you soon.